Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. Not so long ago, I did this slow motion video, how to do slow motion using DaVinci Resolve. However, since I did that video, there's been an update in DaVinci Resolve 19 for the speed warper effect. It has now different modes and can do a better job, maybe, because that is what we're going to figure out in this video. We're going to take the same shot I did back then with the popcorn, and we're just going to see if it does a better job than previously. So without further ado, let's jump into DaVinci Resolve 19 and have a look at the speed warper tool improvements, if any, in DaVinci Resolve 19. Let's get right to the video. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve having a look at the update to the speed warp in DaVinci Resolve 19. And the speed warper is only available in the studio version. So if you do not have the studio version, you can't use the speed warper effect. Anyway, let's just get right to it. So I have this clip here, which is shot at 120 frames a second. And I have made this into a timeline on 24 frames, so it will run my 120 frames in a 24 frame timeline. So it'll be this slow as it is right now here, running the clip. And you can see out of the 120 frames, it's pretty slow, but we want to make this like super slow motion. And the way we can do that here is by selecting the clip, and we'll go up to the inspector here. And in the inspector, we can go down to the speed change. And in this case, we want to speed down. I mean, we can go really crazy with this, but I think for this example here, we are just going to do it like 50%. And let's see, need to just make it fit here. So now we have this running at 50%. And of course, you can see now it's jerky and a bit making weird movements. But we can make this look better just by going into real time and scaling. And in here, I'm just going to use the optical flow. And the optical flow should actually be available in the free version. So here we have it with optical flow. Optical flow is making it less jerky, but it's also making a lot of strange artifacts. And that's not really what we want. So if we go into the motion estimation here, we can change this into enhance better, which is going to make the best possible way of using this slow motion effect here. And this can still be done in the free version, by the way. So here we have the slow-mo with the optical flow and enhance better. This is where the update comes in, because if we go into motion estimation and we change this into speed warp, we have a speed warp fast or a speed warp better. The fast one is actually the new one, which is doing a very, very quick job at rendering, because normally you wouldn't be able to run a speed warp on this system at all. And now I can run it at 4 frames a second, which is not good, but trust me, it is way better than running it with the speed warp better, because that is just going to run like half a frame a second or something. So we're going to let it render just for a quick second here, and then you will have a look at it.
A few seconds later.
Okay, so now the render is done and we can have a look at the clip right here. So what the optical flow and the speed warp are doing is it's adding in missing frames to fill in the gaps in between the frames. So here we have a look at it, and it is going to maybe add some artifacts here and there, but overall this is pretty good for the new fast way of using the speed warp. Also, just want to go to a quick example on this clip here. We have this clip here, this girl dancing. This is a 24 clip, a stock clip. And you know, if we wanted this to go slow, we could do the same thing by going into the speed, and we're going to change this to 50. Again, so we have this, and it's half the speed here. I'm just going to enlarge it a bit. So now we have this at the half of the speed, and we are having all of these weird motions. And we can do the same thing going into optical flow. In fact, I can show you the enhanced better, which is what you can do in the free version. So you can see we have some very strange artifacts here because of the way this works. And even though I changed this to enhanced better, it's going to add these strange motions here. However, if we go and we change this into speed warp faster, and here we have the optical flow with the speed warp fast, and we can see that these artifacts have now disappeared. We had before, they're all gone, which I think is kind of cool. So I'll just quickly jump into another timeline, and I'll show you some different examples on these two clips in different speeds and in different options. Okay, so first off, just going to run through the normal clip. Here we have it slowed down to 50% at the speed warp faster. And here we have the same clip down to 50%, but at the speed warp better. So just to compare, we have the popcorn clip right here. First, we are having the version with the speed warp faster version, as you see right here. And finally, we have the speed warp better version right here. So this is a look at the new speed warp update in DaVinci Resolve 19. I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.